Hello my dear students, welcome to the lecture on the fifth unit, that is the canals. So today I am going to cover the definition of the canals and also the classification of the canals based on the different factors. So let us start the lecture. So first we will go through what is the definition of the canal. So canal is nothing but it is an artificial waterway constructed to allow the passage of boats or ships inland or to convey the water for the irrigation purpose. So that is we are calling as the canal. And it is also an artificial water course or extensively modified natural channel used for inland water transport or to control the diversion of water for drainage or the irrigation. So this arrangement we are calling as the canal. So next we'll go through the classification of the canals based on different factors. So usually we'll classify the canal based on the different factors. So it may be based on the nature of the supply source, or it may be based on the functions, or it may be type of the boundary surface soil and the financial output, and based on the discharge, and finally we'll study based on the canal alignment. So this is the very important topics. So based on this classification of canals, you'll get the question in your university exam. So let us start the first classification. So based on the nature of this supply source, we are classifying the canals mainly into two types. First one is the permanent canal, second one is the inundation canal. So first we'll study about the permanent canal. So permanent canal is a type of a canal in which water is available throughout the year, and this type of canal is having the generally directed from a permanent source of supply water bodies. So several permanent hydraulic structures are constructed in this type of canal for water regulation. So in this type of canal we are getting the supply of water throughout the year, so that we are calling as the permanent canal. So in the figure also you can see the image of the permanent or the perennial irrigation canal. So next we'll study about the inundation canal. So inundation canal is nothing but it is a type of a canal in which water is available only during the flood periods. So if you compare this inundation canal with the permanent canal, so in case of permanent canal you are getting the supply of water throughout the year, but in case of inundation canal you will not get the water supply throughout the year, only during the flood periods we are getting the supply of water to this particular type of the canal. So that is the major difference between permanent canal and the inundation canal. So next we'll study about the classification of the canal based on the function of the canal. So there are five classification. First one will be based on the irrigation canal, second one will be power canal, then third one will be feeder canal, fourth one is carrier canal, and final one will be the navigational canal. So let us start the first type, that is the irrigation canal. So a canal aligned along the boundaries of cultivatable area in order to supply the water for the purpose of agriculture is called as the irrigation canal. So mainly we are using this type of canal for cultivatable areas in order to supply the water. So in the image also you can see the type of canal, that is the irrigation canal. So next we'll study about the power canal. So power canal is nothing but it is a type of canal constructed especially for the generation of the hydropower. So that is termed as the power canal. So next we'll study about the feeder canal. So as the name indicates, feeder canal is nothing but it is used to feed the two or more other canals or the branch canals. So that we are calling as the feeder canal. So next we'll study about the carrier canal. So a carrier canal is it having the multifunction canal, so which serves as the purpose of the both irrigation as well as the feeder canal. So it will work in both the conditions. So first one is for irrigation and second one is for the feeder canal. So that is called as the carrier canal. So next we'll go for the navigational canal. So usually this type of canal is used for navigational purposes, and this type of canal we are calling as the navigation canal. So usually the water level required in a navigational canal is generally a lot higher to accommodate the large ships and vessels. So this type of canal is useful for the navigational purpose. So next we'll study about the classification of canals based on the boundary surface of canal. So there are major three types which we are having in boundary surface of canal. First one will be the alluvial canal, second one will be the non-alluvial canal, and third one will be the rigid surface canal. So first we'll study about the alluvial canal. So if the canal is excavated in alluvial soils such as silt, sand or gravel, so such type of canal we are calling as the alluvial canal. In the figure also you can imagine the type of the canal. And second one will be non-alluvial canal. So if the boundary surface of the canal is of non-alluvial soils, for example loam, clay or rock, so if you construct this type of canal based on such conditions, so that is called as non-alluvial canal. In the figure also you can see the type of non-alluvial canal. So next we'll study about the rigid surface canal. So rigid surface canals also comes under the non-alluvial canals because here the boundary surface of the canal is lined artificially with a hard layer of lining material. So usually for lining material we are using the cement, concrete or stones. So such type of canal we are calling as the rigid surface canal. So next we'll go for the classification of the canal based on the financial output. So there are two types. First one will be the protective canal, second one will be the productive canal. So in case of protective canal, so relief work projects which are constructed to protect a particular area from the shortage of water, so in such cases we are using the protective canal. So in the figure also you can see the where there is a shortage of water. So next we'll study about the productive canal. So in the case of productive canal, so these are the canals, those which will produce the or increase the revenue for its maintenance and running costs, and also to recover the initial investment made on the construction of the canal. So usually it is said to be a good canal if it is recovers 6% of its initial investment per annum. So in the case of productive canal, so in the figure also you can see some example regarding the productive canal. So next we'll go for the classification based on the discharge. So usually there are five types based on the discharge. First one will be the main canal, second one will be the branch canal, third one major distributory canal, fourth one minor distributory canal, and last one will be the filled canal. So first we'll go for the main canal. So in the figure also you can see the different parts, that is the filled channel, minor distributory, head regulator, main canal, then cross regulator, branch canal, then major distributories, then filled channels. So this is an arrangement for different types of the canal structure. So first we'll study about the main canal. So the main canal takes off directly from a river or the reservoir. So it carries water in large amounts to feed the branch and distributory canals. So usually for this type of canal, we are getting directly the water from the reservoir or the river. So from this main canal, again the water will divert it towards the branch canals. That is the next type, which is branch canal. So the branch canal takes off from main canals at regular intervals. So these canals supply water to major and minor distributor canals, and the discharge of this particular canal will be generally over 5 m³/s. So this is the range of this particular type of the branch canal. So next we'll study about the major distributory canal. So the major distributory canal takes off from the branch canal, or in some cases from the main canal, and the range for this particular canal will be the lies in between 0.25 to 5 m³/s. So this is the discharge range for major distributory canal. So next type will be the minor distributory canal. So in the case of minor distributory canal, it takes off from the major distributories and sometimes directly from the branch canal, and usually its range is below 0.25 m³/s. So that is the discharge range for minor distributory canal. So try to remember these discharge ranges. So next one will be the filled channels. So filled channels are also known as the water courses, or small channels excavated by cultivators in the irrigation field. So these channels are fed by the distributor canals and branch canals. So such types we are calling as the filled channels. Next, we'll study about the last classification based on the canal alignment. So there are three types. First one will be the ridge canal, second one contour canals, and the third, that is the last one, side slope canal. So first we'll go for the ridge canal. So the canal aligned along the ridge line or watershed line of an area is said to be ridge canal or watershed canal. So since it is running at the peak altitude of the area, irrigation on both sides of the canal up to the larger extent of the area is possible in this particular type of the ridge canal. In the figure also you can see the example for the ridge type of the canal. So next we'll study about the contour canal. So usually a canal aligned roughly parallel to the contour of the area is called a contour canal, and in this type of canal can be seen in hilly regions. So usually this type of canal you can see in the case of hilly regions. So since it is parallel to the contour line, the ground on one side of the canal is higher, and hence the irrigation is possible only on the other side of the canal in this particular type of the canal, that is the contour canal. And next, the last classification, that is the side slope canal. So a canal aligned nearly perpendicular to the contour of the area is called the side slope canal, and it is located neither on the ridge line nor on the valley line, but it is approximately in between them, and also it is parallel to the natural drainage line, and hence no cross drainage works are required in this particular type of the canal, that is side slope canal. So first you go through all the classification of the canals, starting with the definition. If you are having any doubts regarding the classification, you can contact me, and also definitely you'll get such questions in your university exam. Explain the classification of the canals based on discharge, based on alignment. So such questions you may get. So try to remember the classification based on each factors. If you face any difficulties, you can contact me, and in the next lecture we will go through some topics that is related to canals. So first you study this. If you are having any doubts, you can contact me. So thank you.